I have to learn the shapes of whatever it is I'm trying to paint. So I do it either by sketching or small paintings usually, until I can feel like I somehow can understand the shape of the thing, like the pigeons or the crows or in this case, the Adirondack. And again, I did a lot of small sketches of these chairs. We go to an island in Maine in the summer, and a lot of the time is spent outdoors around Adirondack chairs.
This painting was actually troublesome until I put the green fence in, which was a last ditch effort to save the painting. And I just made it up and threw it in there. And I feel like I like what happened when the fence went in.
This one was a painting of a lemon that didn't work out. So it was just gonna get trashed, but I put some crows in it and it turned it into a green egg or something. But I don't know why. I love crows and I love pigeons. I love the shape of them and I love how they, I love their feet and I love how they, just how they go around in the world. I was coming out of the parking garage and I suddenly just saw the pigeons with the light on them and realized how beautiful they were. So I became obsessed with pigeons for a while. And again, I started small and then ended up with a bunch of large paintings of pigeons as shapes. One year every day I made a small 4x6 painting of this gateway between the field that my house is in and the next field down. And then after making, I don't know, a few months worth of those little daily paintings of the scene, I started to work really large and did a few large paintings, and this is one of them. And this one, I think I often tend to get tighter as I go along, but this one loosened up. I had fun with the turquoise reflection on the rocks from the sky. But that's the field, that's the gateway that I walk through. There's actually trees all along, and the little paintings are much more densely populated with trees. But there's a certain time of year where these trees just glow, maybe one or two days, but I haven't been.
I took a sabbatical 15 years ago, and Rob and I drove cross country, so miles and days of just going along looking at these cows until finally you just realize, oh my God, they're so beautiful. And they're always eating, they have to eat all the time. So I came back and just started painting these cattle. And this shape is the same as this shape. I started again with little ones. And I think this might have been the last painting of the cattle. On our farm, Deer Ridge Farm in Townsend, there are two old barns that are connected. One of them is sagging, seriously sagging, and they're so beautiful. And then another obsessive period in my life where it was just paint the barns, paint the barns, paint the barns. I've been worried about them coming down. This one has to come down probably. But meanwhile, just looking at them and looking at how they're connected and the space between them and the way they sags. They're beautiful. The light hits them, and where the light hits them, they're orange, and where the shadow hits them, they're like a rosy maroon almost. So the paint is so old, you could never recreate how beautiful. Pretty old landscape, and I painted it quite a few times actually, because I'm very interested in the way the fields interact with each other. So this is one of the just small versions of it. This is a later landscape from a series of pears in the landscape, where I'm very interested in pears because of their shape and their beauty, and they taste great. And then I was somehow the landscapes and the pears merged for a while. This is a scene from my backyard up at the Blueberry House. And it just, you know, sometimes you just walk out the door of a place you've seen for 20 years and you just suddenly see it. The light is hitting it in a way. The light was hitting these viney things that were growing up the pines. And it just was just magnificent to me. The more I painted, the more I realized everything was just really about light and shadow. These great chairs that I have in the backyard that I got at the, I think, hospital fair days or something. And they throw these shadows. This one I like because certain shadows feel, just so geometric and sharp and a sunny day. The way the light will fall on part of something and not on another. This shows the underpainting. This has a red underpainting, for a while I was doing a lot of red underpainting, which I like that with a lot of green. But for me, this painting is something about these shadows that makes it interesting. And the arrangement of the chairs, they're always getting moved, you know, they're getting dragged around, and they're just great chairs. Just a little way from representation, but these are the blueberry bushes. We have like 1,000 blueberry bushes up at our house. And so there's a lot of time spent around blueberries. Rob does a lot of maintenance, we do a lot of picking, there's just a lot about the blueberries, and they're planted in rows, and they go through seasonally, they go through these color changes. They're beautiful, beautiful plants. They flower, and then they fruit, and then they turn red, and they're beautiful, and I love the way they're laid out. So when you come upon them from the field below, you come up and then this is just the sense of the world, the blueberry world. So this was another obsessive period of lemons. And what I'm noticing as I go around is, you know, that it's all about various succeeding, falling in love with something, and then needing to paint it obsessively for a while. This is my grandmother's picture. This is an older painting. And I don't think I usually do this sort of thing, and I never did, but I wanted to paint her, the picture of my grandmother. And this is, you know, towards the end of the pear obsession, perhaps, where they started to get a little more stylized. This is a part of a series of, I think there were four on this day, where the pears, there were two pears on a pink plate, and gosh, they just were so beautiful. They were just so beautiful. The paint, I don't know, just the chipped edges of the plate and the shadows. I like these in a sort of Gauguin way of flattening them a little bit. This was really a drawing that I put some paint on. But there's something about the energy of the pencil line along with the paint that I like. It's just really a drawing, but it's, there's the springiness to it that appealed to me. And then the pears became, the pears started to go into a little more cosmic circuit where pears and moons started to, I guess these pears are kind of on a beach or certain, anyway, that the constellations and the moons and the suns started to react, to interact with the pears. Most of them have to do with growing up where my mother was a New Yorker, but we lived north of Boston, but we used to drive down to New York all the time to see her family. And, you know, crossing certain bridges and just going from one type of landscape to another. So this, I think this series pretty much had to do with landforms and waterforms connecting with each other in the sense of traveling into a more populated, a whole different kind of life than when we first. There's always some sense of water and population for me, and ships and bridges, ships docking or coming in, and that sort of waterfront stuff. Again, just trying to learn the shape and what they, something about the nature of crows. Something about them, and not getting it all, but trying to figure out something about them. Yeah, and that thing about radishes where they're so, you know, that you separate them and they have a whole thing going on. Each one is like springing out with its green leaves, and they always bunch them, and they bunch them all together, and then you know, they can spring apart with this incredible leaf energy. You're just good.